In our final trade of the day, someone we appreciate having on our show, it's Tom White at TD Ameritrade here to give his final trades. Thanks for coming on the show.
It's good to be back.
So some unusual options activity has been happening in Nordstrom. What is it telling you as a trader?
Well, I think they're a little bit bullish on the name. The retail sector got hit a little bit earlier this year, but the shares from mid-March are up about 20% right now. And I was on the show previously last quarter talking about JWN or Nordstrom ahead of earnings, and I liked it for a pullback around that $41, $42 share level, which it did get to. It actually hit just below 41. So we got into that trade on a covered call basis where we got to buy the shares and we sold some calls to the upside for a neutral to bullish position. Stock's up 20%, like I said. So momentum has picked up in there. One thing about Nordstrom compared to the other retail names is the fact that they've got better margins, and margins equals better revenue. So they've outperformed a little bit on that in that space. But we've seen the whole sector as a whole kind of pick up. We've got a lot more earnings today, tomorrow, in that sector with Macy's, JCPenney,
absolutely,
some other
it's
names.
Big retail
and then we've got retail sales tomorrow morning that come out from the government. So that'll kind of set the tone. I don't like JWN at these levels where it's gone up 20% in about a month, but we're already in the name.
So what would be your trade?
On any pullback, I'd probably get into some more, maybe take some off ahead of earnings tonight after the close.
And then Procter & Gamble's also on your list.
Yep, Procter & Gamble's pulled back about 6% from earnings. It gave us a mixed result. But it's underperformed the overall market as we're at all-time highs. I like the name. It's got a 3% dividend yield, which is great for that name. And valuations are getting low after that pullback. We like it for a little bit of neutral to upside. We think it's going to stabilize. As long as the economy stays solid and we don't get any geopolitical risk, we think Procter & Gamble can maybe move to the upside a little bit, maybe in that 2 to 4% range, from 86.87 all the way up to 89.90.
Oh, nice. Mm-hmm. Final stock, McDonald's. What do you do with McDonald's here?
I don't get this stock. that's the big thing for me. I don't go to McDonald's. I haven't for 15, 20 years. I don't get it, but...
You don't like the Filet-O-Fish?
I do not.
A treat of all treats.
I
get one about every 5 years.
It's one of those names where you have to look at the balance sheet and what the company is doing. The new CEO is doing a great job. They're growing domestically for the first time in a couple of years. The all-day breakfast worked out real well for them. And they're cutting some costs. One thing that you have to note about McDonald's and some of these other fast food names is employees. It makes up a big chunk of their costs. If they turn to this electronic kiosk mobile system, that's going to cut a lot of employees. They don't like to talk about it that much because it's kind of a red flag.
Yeah,
it is.
Yep.
It is. And that's helping. And they're also ramping up their mobile pay and in-store ordering through your mobile app.
You almost sound bullish.
I'm not bullish at these levels. On a technical basis, the stock's way overbought. But if it consolidates, maybe pulls back a little bit, it'll gain another footing.
What would you do with the trade?
I'd probably, if I did anything right here, I'd probably get shorted to maybe a neutral trade where I'd sell something. I use options. I'd sell some call verticals on the upside where I can limit my risk and still take a neutral to bearish stance in there.
Always a pleasure, Tom. Thank you.
Thank you.